We took apart the 15W wireless charging module for Tesla Model Y several months ago. You can click the upright corner to check if you're interested. And today we got another wireless charging module for BWM 5 series. But it only supports 5W wireless charging. Let's take it apart and check its internal components. The front of the plastic case is matte, and the buffer on each can prevent the phone from sliding off. The phone and battery icons in the middle help you recognize the charging area. There are several labels pasted on the back. The large metal heatsink can enhance heat dissipation. Here is the input socket, and the coaxial antenna connector is here. The model is WCH-184, and it supports input of 12V, 1.5A. The BWM is printed on another label, and it has qualified to different standards. The size of this module is about 165 by 87 by 23mm, and the weight is about 301 grams. Next, let's use the screwdriver to take it apart. Remove the screws under two labels on the back. Then we can easily take out the PCBA module. The wireless charging coil is on the front, and the thick aluminum heatsink is on the back and fixed with screws. The input socket is at the top, 6 prongs in total. Then remove the heatsink. A layer of metal shielding is under it, and all components are on the internal PCB. The copper on each of the PCB is used for grounding. Let's try to introduce every single component to you. Firstly, here is the coaxial antenna connector we just mentioned. Here is the mass controller from NXP, a 5W automotive controller for multi-coil wireless charging transmitter. And the external crystal oscillator for mass controller is 8 MHz. Those two MLCCs are used for output filtering. This buck converter is from MPS, which steps down the input voltage. It integrates 0.50 MOSFET and adopts SOT23-6 package. This is the 33 microhenry buck inductor. The output voltage from buck converter is regulated by the MPS linear regulator. It can output a 3.3 volts voltage to power the mass controller. This is a 10 microhenry filter inductor at the input. The little fuse TVS styled is used for input surge protection. Another 10 microhenry filter inductor. The diode MOSFET is used to control the wireless charging and adopts SO8 package. 40 volts, 50 milliohm. Here are multiple MLCCs for input filtering. The synchronous buck converter is from MPS and adopts QFN package. 36 volts, 40 milliohm for high side and 20 milliohm for low side. The buck inductor is from Worth, 10 microhenry. The half-bridge power stage consists of 4 independent MOSFETs, SMD capacitors, and inductors. The power transistor for wireless charging is from ON Semiconductor, 30 volts, 10.5 milliohm. Those 3 MLCCs are connected in parallel for power supply filtering. 4 white MPO capacitors are used for resonant wireless charging. This output filter inductor is from Worth, 1 microhenry. The other inductor is the same. Those two output resonant capacitors are connected in series with a coil. Those 3 MOSFETs for charging switching are from Infineon and are qualified to automotive standard. 100 volts, 22 milliohm. This high-speed CAN transceiver is from NXP and provides an interface between CAN protocol controller and the physical bus. Here is the filter inductor for CAN bus. The dual operational amplifier is from Microchip and is used for signal amplification. The coil is placed in a plastic frame. And here is the connector for connecting the module. Separate the coil and PCB. Some components are on the back of the PCB, like power transistors, drivers, etc. 3 dual operational amplifiers are from Microchip. Here are 2 drivers used to drive the power transistors. Finally, here is the bidirectional current sense amplifier for input current detection. It's from Texas Instruments and with send voltage is 26 volts. Well, that's all components of this BMW wireless charging module. Although it only supports up to 5W, all components have qualified to automotive standards. The front and back sides are covered with metal shielding, and the huge aluminum heatsink can enhance heat dissipation. Pretty impressive. Okay, that's all for today's video. If you like this video, please drop a like, leave your comments, and subscribe to us. And I'll catch you guys in the next video. Bye!